The controversial Lift Station 87 project's price tag has swelled to $32 million, and it has hit even more delays.
Add another $7 million to the overall cost of Lift Station 87.
Stopping our news today at noon, a controversial lift station project in Sarasota just grew more expensive.
The lift station, which is located in Lukewood Park, is a wastewater system that will be replacing Lift Station 7, and it will be used for about one-third of the city of Sarasota's wastewater.
It's 2 years from completion and about 10 years past the deadline. Again, the cost has gone from about $9 million to about $50 million.
Well, Lift Station 87 requires a little bit of explanation because it's a head scratcher for everyone. How do you go from under 10 million to nearly 70 million? We had a lift station on Orange Avenue called Lift Station 7. There was a leak and into Hudson Bayou, and the argument was that this was because it was old infrastructure. So they decided that they would get a design for a new lift station, 87. At that point, it was going to be sent down by the high school, where they're building the museum now. And they didn't want it over there. And then it came up to the idea of putting it where it is now. What they hadn't taken into account was that the rocks around the bayou were so hard that when they tried to drill underneath it, so-called micro-tunneling, it failed. And so the first whole project literally went by the by. Then the city tried to sue the contractor because it wasn't the contractor's fault. It was a stupid idea. So they lost that lawsuit. So that increased the amount of money that they spent and obviously put them years behind. And what you've got now is Osprey Avenue being closed again for the second time in 5 years for another 9 months, because they didn't have the foresight to do what was obviously going to need to be done to facilitate the manholes and the pipes that they need for the lift station. So it's just another example of what happens when government runs large infrastructure projects. You end up with a bad outcome because it's not their money. They get paid the same whether they do a good or a bad job. And once it reached 50 million, what's 60 million? They say it's going to stop at 67 million. I'm not sure that it is. We simply can't afford to spend 70 million bucks on each one. But this was driven by a false narrative. That leak wasn't a leak. That leak was a broken alarm. And when the alarm failed, it carried on pouring out. That's what it's designed to do. The alarm should have blocked it off. And a group of neighborhood activists, of which Susan Chapman was a big part, pushed to have this moved out of their neighborhood. It's no mistake. In the same way as they don't want ambulances going down Orange, and they didn't want a lift station on Orange either. So they pushed it out and out of their neighborhood, the quintessential not in my backyard. And the cost of that has been nearly 70 million bucks, and huge disruption to all the people that live on Osprey Avenue.